The NBA All-Star Game is our chance to see the best players in the league play with and against each other to see who will come out on top. There are flashy dunks, not a lot of defense, and that one player that takes it way more seriously than everyone else and ends up winning MVP because he's the only one who actually tried. It's fun! In this video, we're going to take a look at some of the best All-Star Game starting lineups in NBA history. Now, since the greatest players dominate for more than a few years, we're breaking this down by decade, starting with the 50s. Old school players usually get forgotten through time, but even most modern NBA fans still know of greats like Bob Cousy, Paul Arizin, Dolph Schayes, Bill Sharman, and Bob Pettit. The 1957 All-Star Game featured all of those greats, most of which made up our top 10 list for their position. Imagine the original magician himself, Bob Cousy, flying around passing the ball to the original stretch four, Dolph Schayes, or trying to stop a team with Bob Pettit and George Yardley flashing around. Yeah, they may not be as well known today, but a lineup of these greats would make for a very entertaining game. For the 60s, we picked the 1961 All-Star Game. Now, you know it's a strong lineup when you have Jerry West and Bill Russell coming off the bench. In the 1961 All-Star Game, the starting lineups for each conference were flooded with all-time greats like Oscar Robertson, Bob Pettit, Elgin Baylor, Wilt Chamberlain, Bob Cousy, and Dolph Schayes. The action was fast. Five players recorded a double-double, with Oscar Robertson just barely missing a triple-double. Five players scored 20 or more points, and the combined score was over 280 points. This was the golden age for the NBA, and the 1961 All-Star Game was the best showcase of that. Next up is the 1970 All-Star Game. The 1970 All-Star Game was the perfect storm. It was somewhere near the end of the careers of legendary players like Oscar Robertson, Jerry West, and Elgin Baylor, and right at the beginning of the careers of other all-time greats like Walt Frazier, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, and Elvin Hayes. It was the crossing of two generations, the proverbial passing of the torch kind of moment, and the stars showed out. Oscar Robertson scored 21 points on 9-for-11 shooting, Kareem recorded a double-double off the bench, Elvin Hayes had 24 points and 15 rebounds, and Willis Reed won MVP after scoring 21 points and grabbing 11 rebounds, en route to helping the East beat the West 142-135. Yeah, don't listen to the old school fans, defense has never been popular at the All-Star Game. For the 1980s, we picked the 1988 All-Star Game. The night after facing each other in a historic dunk contest, Michael Jordan and Dominic Wilkins teamed up in the 1988 All-Star Game, along with several other all-time greats. Seriously, the rosters for this game is basically everyone's top 20 list. The starters featured Bird, Dominic, Jordan, Isaiah, Malone, both of them, Magic, and Hakeem. The reserves included Ewing, Barkley, Drexler, and Kareem. Yes, those were the reserves. Jordan scored 40 points, and Kareem set the record for the most points in All-Star Game history, which he held for 15 years. As usual, it was a high-scoring affair, but I doubt anyone cared. Imagine Isaiah Thomas running the break with Jordan and Dominic Wilkins ready to slam it home, or three of the five Showtime Lakers ready on the other end. The only lineup that could rival the 88 All-Star Game roster was probably that of our next entry for the 1990s, which was the 1992 All-Star Game. The 1992 All-Star Game is considered by some to be the greatest All-Star Game of all time. It was basically the dream team for the All-Star Game. The rosters included legends like Michael Jordan, Magic Johnson, Karl Malone, Isaiah Thomas, Hakeem Olajuwon, John Stockton, Charles Barkley, and Patrick Ewing, not to mention other greats like Clyde Drexler, David Robinson, James Worthy, Dikembe Mutombo, and Dennis Rodman. Seriously, from 1 to 25, this roster was loaded. The 92 All-Star Game was notable for another reason. It was Magic Johnson's final game. He went out with a bang, scoring 25 points, going toe-to-toe with Michael Jordan and Isaiah Thomas, earning him MVP honors. In fact, the last 14 seconds of the game weren't even played after Magic hit a three-pointer and the entire squad of players gathered around to say their goodbyes. On to the 2000s and the 2009 All-Star Game. The 2009 All-Star Game is the most intriguing in recent history because it features several players who have since faded or had their careers cut short. You had players like Yao Ming and Brandon Roy who suffered critical injuries and never again reached this peak. And then players like Devin Harris, Rashard Lewis, and Danny Granger, who no one would think of as All-Stars today, but who were in their primes at the time. Other than that, it was actually a pretty awesome roster. I mean, Shaq was the last guy on the West roster. That's how deep it was. The starters were Kobe, Chris Paul, Stoudemire, Duncan, and Yao for the West, and Dwight Howard, LeBron, Wade, Garnett, and AI for the East. This was actually the first time that Kobe and Shaq played together since their very public breakup. They also both won co-MVP honors, which we're sure was a total coincidence and not done to create a storyline at all. Lastly, for the 2010s, we picked the 2012 All-Star Game. The 2012 All-Star Game is probably the best one that most young NBA fans can remember. Both teams were absolutely loaded with talent. The West roster featured Kevin Durant, Kobe Bryant, Blake Griffin, Chris Paul, Russell Westbrook, Dirk Nowitzki, Tony Parker, and Steve Nash. The East roster consisted of superstars like Dwayne Wade, LeBron James, Dwight Howard, Carmelo Anthony, Derrick Rose, Chris Bosh, Deron Williams, Rajon Rondo, and Paul Pierce. Absolutely no defense was played, which means there was plenty of dunks and highlight plays. It was one of the highest scoring All-Star games in league history, with a combined score over 300 points. Kevin Durant won MVP honors after scoring 36 points, grabbing 7 rebounds and 3 steals, dishing out 3 assists, and being pretty much the only guy who showed up to play a real game. So those are the best All-Star Game rosters by decade, at least according to us. So what's your favorite All-Star Game moment? Let us know in the comments. Make sure you follow us on social media to see previews of our videos before we post them. Follow me on Twitter at @MTV_Sydney. And don't forget to thumbs up this video and subscribe for more NBA mixes and top 10s.